Hey, yo, Esteban. What's up? We got any reviews up yet?
It's top secret.
I like that. I like that.
Yo, Universal.
What's good?
We putting any reviews up?
That's classified.
I like that. I like that.
Yo, WaxGrooveTV. Welcome back. Back like cook crack.
Sprat.
I got the homie with me.
Esteban Ray, nigga who don't play. Was born in May. Fuck wrong with your day. I know it's June. The niggas is coming soon. See all you little fruity niggas out there. Spoon.
I go by the general universal ruler. And we are back at it again.
Uh-huh.
Switching up a little bit today. We don't have no mixtape or album for you. We got a nice little track review. Got this Pusha T, Jay-Z, Drug Dealers Anonymous.
Yep.
So let's just jump right into it, man.
Ain't nothing else to do. You jump right in like a double dutch. Swinging and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so this was a dope track. I enjoyed the track quite a bit.
No pun intended.
Production on it was on point. And it was...
What's his name? DJ Dahi.
Yeah, DJ Dahi. Dahi, I can't pronounce it.
I'ma say Dahi.
We got that rap genius up in the back who was going through that as we were listening to it just to kind of catch the breakdown of it.
Mm-hmm.
But I enjoyed this, man. It was a bounce back for Jay-Z because his verse on that All The Way Up remix is absolutely terrible.
I think that's the Jay-Z laugh.
Remember that? He used to do that?
I mean, he probably still do that.
He probably still got it in him.
Yeah, who knows?
But, Pusha T came through as usual, and I mean, it was just a nice.
I think he definitely set the tone.
He did, absolutely, and it was just double entendre on top of double entendre right from the start.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what's crazy too? Like I was telling y'all before we started recording, when it comes to that cocaine rap, it never gets old with him because he always finds a different way to flip it.
Definitely.
Now most niggas be rapping about drugs for 20 years and it's like, or just the same shit, like Wiz Khalifa will give you the same verse now all the time.
Terrible.
We're pushing T, it's like, he's still
not
talking.
Not Wiz fan, but it's just getting terrible.
Get that Charles Barkley treatment going forward.
It's
but
like,
yeah.
It's like he got dreadlocks and shit just stopped. Like your brain stopped being creative.
Well, I'm just, every time he talks about moving them bricks or flipping them bricks, man, he just come correct with it every time. He
reinvents himself with it all the time.
What'd he say? I want to see how many of those, how many Madonnas could fit in that Mazda fit. home wordplay. His wordplay is crazy. I love it. Jay-Z.
I like that.
The way Jay-Z came.
Shout out to Rock Nation. I like that.
Oh man.
Jay-Z definitely did rejuvenate himself, you know, on his joint.
What did he say when he first started the track? He's like Giorgio
Federico Fellini.
Federico Fellini, which happens to be an Italian director and screenwriter.
Mm-hmm.
So we basically saying, you know, his words, he paint a vivid picture, man. His words is coming to life when he's spitting them bars. And like I said,
brought his shit to fruition, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it. And like I said, man, it was a bounce back because that All The Way Up remix was terrible. And this is the type of Jay-Z I like to hear. I don't like to really hear him when on that pop shit or just like when he's lazy about his rapping. This almost brings you back to that Reasonable Doubt kind of feeling with Jay-Z, which
don't get
anymore.
Don't get me wrong, man. There's some pop shit that I fuck with, like, then when he was on Pharrell's frontman, he fucking smashed that verse.
He did.
You know what I'm saying? That was a hard verse. I still go back and listen to that from time to time.
I almost feel like Pusha T made him step his game up, though, being honest. Like,
that's
he couldn't just be
that's
him.
That's exactly what it was. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to say he couldn't be him, because I'm a Jay-Z fan. You know what I'm saying? This nigga's not.
You can't say I'm not a fan. I'm a fan of his early work. After Volume 3, up until, I wasn't really fucking with it. I'm not a fan of like the blueprints or none of that, but yeah, man, I enjoyed this. This is like 9-6 Jay-Z, to be honest with you. which you don't get that much. The little interlude or chorus was tough. That
meant a lot.
Yeah, there's a lot of history behind it.
Put a lot of substance in this whole song.
For the those of y'all who may not know, it's a news anchor, a very young news anchor, ignorant news anchor. I think her name is Tony Lane, something like that. But anyway, she made a comment about Jay-Z selling drugs for 14 years, and she's just really condescending. Charlamagne Tha God was on her her little show and had to put her in check and kind of school her, which is pretty hilarious. But
shouts out Charlamagne for that, you know what I'm saying?
Definitely. But that little interlude, or just using that little snippet before going into Jay-Z's verse, kind of, it added to it. It, like you said, it gave it that substance, jumping right into the track, or his verse, I should say. But all in all, man, this is a dope ass track.
Definitely, no pun intended, dope ass track. See, this track is crack. This
man, track is crack.
It's dope. It's crack.
Shit make your mouth water. Yeah. You know what I mean? See, it's crazy.
Shit make you itch.
Like he said, it's dope. You know it's crack. This shit make your mouth water. Pusha T know what he's doing. He really a hustler because he got you feeling for more. He got you feeling for that album.
Yes.
And if this is...
I'm looking for that King Push.
If this is like what we have to look forward to on the album.
Even this fucking album title got the double entendre.
Mm-hmm.
King Push, nigga.
But even the project he put out last year was dope.
A lot of motherfuckers out there don't even know what that is. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of new generation kids out there, or just new generation rap listeners, y'all single-minded. Y'all suffer from single-mindedness. That's the problem with a lot of y'all cats. Y'all, you know.
So,
kicking it like kung fu and shit.
How you rating this track? If you had to rate this track,
what would
you?
Nah, this one goes Chili Pepper.
Yeah, man. Absolutely. This track is dope.
Everything was on point. Everybody verse was on point. Even the little interlude, snippet, whatever you want to call it.
And I see myself listening to this quite a bit.
You know what I'm saying? We just did listen to it quite a bit. You know what I'm saying?
You know what's nice about this track? It's not like no radio single, but it is a perfect track to kind of get his buzz going again for his new album.
Oh no, we lost the rap genius. I can even see this like buzzing Hov back up.
Yeah, absolutely.
He might start putting out a couple more things and whatnot. You know? Maybe the blue hue on it.
Yeah, this is definitely a buzz. Get a buzz for Hov too. I mean, if you think about it, especially with him jumping on that Fat Joe and Remy, and then jumping on this, so clearly he got some things in the works if he's doing features again.
Yeah, he's probably back in the studio heavy, trying to get, you know, one up on his spouse and whatnot.
Yeah, who knows what's gonna happen with that situation? But yeah, man.
It's just a whole thought process of mine. You know, you see it. His wife's doing things still, like he feels like I gotta
step back out there, sharpen his sword and get back out there.
Yeah, you know.
But
even though he's like much older.
About 13 years.
I don't know,
he's old as shit, but
I mean, he was born in like 69, so he's gonna be like 47. You know.
But let us know what you think. You know, let us know in the comment section what we should review next. Like I said, it's a dope track. Definitely check it out if you can. Be on the lookout.
Niggas believe that? Nigga about to be like 47?
That's crazy. He's old as fuck.
47. He's 46 right now. 47.
We'll be on the lookout. We got much more to come. And
I mean, ain't nothing wrong. He got money, you know. He do his thing. But like my man Universal said, be on the lookout. We got more coming. More drumming. Phil drumming.
Some announcements coming soon.
You know, plates for y'all cats that's hungry, yum yummin'. Mm-hmm.